Stop. Seriously, stop watching the video for 1 second. I want you to look at the underside of your wrist. Go on, look at it. If you see blue veins, congratulations. Your ancestors probably survived the Ice Age. If you see green veins, congratulations. Your ancestors probably invented civilization while everyone else was freezing. And if you can't see your veins at all, congratulations. Your ancestors were biologically bulletproof. Because here is a weird fact. Humans are the only primate on Earth that comes in a color-coded gradient. If you shave a chimpanzee, which please don't do that, they are incredibly strong and will rip your face off. But if you did, you'd see their skin is basically all the same color underneath the fur. But us? We decided to lose the fur, walk out of the jungle, and spread across the planet completely naked. Which, evolutionarily speaking, was a terrible idea. Because the moment we lost our fur, we entered a biological war with a giant burning ball of gas. And your skin color? It isn't a race. It isn't a social construct. It is a battle scar. It is a truce line drawn between two vitamins that are trying to kill each other. Here is exactly how it works. Imagine your body is being pulled apart by two invisible giants in a game of tug-of-war. Giant number one is folate. This is vitamin B9. It's crucial for making babies and ensuring your DNA doesn't scramble itself like an egg. The problem? The sun hates folate. Intense UV radiation destroys it. So, if you live near the equator and you have pale skin, the sun zaps your blood, destroys your folate, and your evolutionary line ends right there. So, giant number one is screaming, "Make the skin darker, we need a shield." But then, there's giant number two, vitamin D. You need the sun to make vitamin D. Without it, your bones turn to jelly, your immune system crashes, and you generally have a bad time. If you have dark skin but you live in gloomy northern Europe, you block too much sun. You can't make the vitamin. So, giant number two is screaming, "Make the skin lighter, we need a solar panel." And you are just the rope in the middle. Every shade of human skin, from the deepest ebony to the ghostliest pale, is just evolution trying to find the Goldilocks zone. Not too dark, not too light, just right for the specific latitude where your great-great-great-grandparents decided to park the tribe. It's a perfect system, in theory. But what happens when you take that system to the extreme? Well, you get some biological superpowers that most people don't even know they have. Let's start with the original model, the armor. If we look at the source code of humanity, specifically populations from places like equatorial Africa, we find the deep ebony skin tone. In the video game of life, this is what happens when you dump all your character stats into defense. Most people think melanin is just a tint, but it's not. It is biological sunscreen, sure, but it's also a structural shield. In these deep ebony tones, the body produces melanin in such abundant quantities that it sometimes actually looks cool or bluish. This isn't for aesthetics. It's because the sun in these regions is a relentless, radioactive laser beam that is trying to scramble your genetic code. This pigmentation is basically a lead wall protecting the DNA inside your cells. It drastically reduces the chance of mutations and skin cancer. For our ancestors living near the equator, this wasn't just a nice to have. It was a hard requirement for survival. If you didn't have this armor, you didn't survive long enough to have kids. But wait, there is a hidden stat boost here that nobody talks about. This skin type demonstrates remarkable efficiency in maintaining overall skin integrity. In simple terms, it's tougher. It resists the breakdown effects of the sun better than anything else. It's the tank class, so dark skin is arguably the superior build. It protects your DNA, it keeps your skin younger for longer, and it stops the sun from cooking you alive. But there is a massive downside to wearing heavy plate armor. What happens when you take that tank class and drop it into a dark, frozen forest where the sun barely shines for 6 months straight? Suddenly, that armor becomes a suffocating cage. And evolution had to do something drastic. It had to strip the armor off. As humans migrated north, leaving the sunny tropics for the gloomy, miserable weather of Europe, that tank-class armor became a death sentence. Why? Because the armor works too well. It blocks the sun so effectively that in low-light environments, you can't make enough vitamin D. Your bones get soft, your immune system crashes, and you don't survive. So, evolution pressed the reset button. It started stripping away the armor to turn the skin into a high-efficiency solar panel. The first step in this downgrade was light golden brown. This popped up in places like the Mediterranean and North Africa. The skin has enough melanin to stop you from burning in the summer, but it's light enough to soak up vitamin D in the winter. It's a perfect equilibrium. Then, things get stealthy with olive-toned skin. This is the ninja build. It's common in southern Europe and the Middle East. It has a neutral base with greenish or gray undertones. But as humans kept walking north, into the land of eternal winter, evolution had to get radical. It invented fair light skin. At this point, the armor is almost gone. By dropping the shields, the skin absorbs UV radiation massively more efficiently. The trade-off? You are now a glass cannon. You have zero defense. You burn easily. But the upside is that you can power your entire skeletal system on 5 minutes of weak, gray sunshine. And finally, we reach the extreme end of the spectrum. Very fair skin. This is the Northern Europe slash Irish build. The melanin concentration here is the lowest possible. The skin is actually milky white or translucent. Remember when I asked you to look at your wrist? If you have this skin type, you can see your veins because the skin is literally see-through. It's not trying to block anything. It is desperate to capture every single photon of light available to stop you from getting rickets. So, basically, dark skin is a shield against the sun trying to laser you. Pale skin is a desperate attempt to not starve to death in the dark. But nature isn't always perfect. Sometimes the printer jams. Sometimes instead of dark or pale, people come out blue. And I don't mean sad, I mean Smurf-level blue. Let me introduce you to the Fugate family of Kentucky. Back in the 1800s, a guy named Martin Fugate moved to the Appalachian Mountains. He had a super rare recessive gene. He married a woman who, by total coincidence, also had the same rare gene. The result? Their kids were blue. This is a condition called methemoglobinemia. Basically, their blood couldn't carry oxygen normally, so it turned chocolate brown, which looks blue through the skin. They lived perfectly healthy lives. They just looked like they were holding their breath for 80 years. But if you weren't born with the glitch, don't worry. You can actually do it to yourself. Enter the condition called argyria. There are people today who have turned permanently gray-blue. How? By eating silver. Some people drink colloidal silver as a home remedy, but the body has no way to get rid of silver, so it stores it in your skin. When the sun hits it, the silver oxidizes, just like an old-timey photograph developing. You literally turn into a living photo negative. And no, you can't scrub it off. You are now permanently the color of a zombie. These are the rare glitches. But there is a much bigger, invisible glitch that is affecting millions of you watching this video right now. And it's not because you're eating silver, it's because you are living in the wrong place. For 99% of human history, you lived where your ancestors lived. If you had deep ebony armor, you lived near the equator. If you had very fair solar panels, you lived in the gloomy north. The system was balanced. The tug of war was a tie, but then we invented something that completely broke evolution, the airplane. Suddenly, you can take a very fair-skinned person whose biology is specifically tuned to ensure maximum absorption of UV rays in low light and drop them in the middle of Australia. What happens? Their solar panel skin doesn't just work, it overloads. The vulnerability to burning that didn't matter in ancient Ireland suddenly matters a lot. They get fried, they get skin cancer. Their biology is a mismatch for their zip code. On the flip side, take someone with rich dark brown skin, designed to shield against DNA damage in high solar exposure, and move them to a cubicle in cloudy Seattle or London. Their armor works too well, it blocks the weak sunlight perfectly, but because they aren't getting the intense sun their skin expects, they can't produce enough vitamin D. They might suffer from bone issues or immune deficiencies unless they take supplements. This is the modern mismatch. Your skin is a map of where your ancestors survived. It tells the story of how they adapted to extreme sunlight or long dark winters. It is a biological record of varied diets, migrations, and climatic shifts. But that map is now outdated. We are running ancient hardware in a modern world. We have olive-tone people working night shifts. We have mahogany brown people living in snowy Canada. We have pale beige people vacationing in the tropics without sunscreen. The Goldilocks war between folate and vitamin D is still happening inside you right now. But for the first time in history, you have to manually manage the truce. So look at your wrist again. Appreciate the veins or the pigment that hides them. It's a survival strategy that kept your bloodline alive for 200,000 years. Just maybe put on some sunscreen if you're a solar panel, and take a vitamin D pill if you're armor. Because evolution is smart, but it's way too slow to keep up with Delta Airlines. Thanks for watching.